Today's topic is data indexing in DBMS. Well, you can see from this figure that stacks are often indexed in database. First of all, why we need index? What is the reason behind we have the requirement of an index? The answer is simple, because we want the searching faster. We want to access the data that we are keeping in the database in a faster way. Yes, so that's why we need index. And if you analyze the typical structure of an index, then you'll find the structure is somewhat like this. Here you'll have one key, and with respect to that, some reference is there. And there, exactly in that particular address, exactly we are keeping the value. Okay, so that is the structure of an index in our database. Now comes to the definition part. What is data indexing, or what is data index? So as I already told you, we want it to organize the data in such a way that we'll have an easy access of the data. So what does that exactly mean? It means that data indexing is nothing but a kind of data structure that is added to a file to provide faster access to that particular data. Got it? So simple answer for that question, that what is data indexing? It is a data structure. Do note it. Now, it reduces the number of blocks that the DBMS has to check. If indexing is there, then we'll not find any difficulty to have the searching to be done in an easy way. Okay, because only few number of blocks that need to be searched, so it is easily accessible. What is that? That is data that you are keeping in that database. Now, how DBMS access data? You know, we have already been gone through them, that read, modify, update, delete. Okay, these are the different operations that we actually perform on the data that we are keeping in the database. Yes or no? We know about that.
We have, sir.
Okay, so we have got that DDL, DML, and DCL. Now, DBMS first transfer the data temporarily to a buffer in main memory. You know about buffer, a temporary location where we are keeping the data. Then data is then transferred,
yes,
okay, between disks and main memory into units known as blocks. I'm repeating the process again. DBMS must transfer the data temporarily to a buffer in the main memory. Then it is transferred between disks and the main memory into units known as blocks. Now let's come to the properties of data index. As I have already shown you the structure of it, so it will contain what? A search key and a reference key, that is a pointer. Search key is an attribute or a set of attributes that is used to look up the records in a file. Then pointer contains the address of where the data is stored in the memory. It can be compared to the card catalog system using public libraries of the past. So as a whole, if you go for the an imagination of this data index, then you can compare it with this catalog system. One, you have key, and then you have a reference. A reference is nothing but the pointer. Key is the attribute that is used to look after that particular record, and pointer is nothing but the address where exactly data is stored. Now we have two types of indices. One is ordered, that is also known as primary and clustering index. And this is used to access the data stored by order of values. Okay, remember it, but in this is for your IDBMS, but I used to actually go through of it whenever it is required. And generally in some higher SEM, I used to discuss this thing in individual lectures. I devote one lecture to like clustering, one lecture to like hashing like that. Now, hashing, I already discussed in our machine learning class of the remedial class. Hash index, you got it. That is secondary index or non-clustering index. Used to access the data that is distributed uniformly across a range of buckets. So parsed ordered index, also known as clustering or primary index. Second, hash index. Now, today's first question is that you need to tell me what an index actually consisting of. Means what is the structure of a database index. Now, ordered index will be having a structure like this. This is ordered from the diagram. It is very much clear that it is organized in an ordered way. Okay. Then hash index. You know about hash index. I discussed already. For hash index, for every value, we need to use another hash function to find out the main or exact value where the data will be stored. Okay. The typical figure for that, like this, root index. This is also known as non-clustered because in the ordered one, you will see some clusters. And by the cluster, we mean a group like this one, okay? But in case of hashing, there is no such type of cluster. There is no such ordering that we are following. We will follow the what the our hash value is exactly. As per the hash value is concerned, we'll keep our value there. And for that, we are following that particular, you know, this table where we are keeping those values. Now, what is the way of choosing one particular indexing technique? First of all, this depends on some five factors: access time, access type, insertion time, deletion time, space overhead. Do note them. I'm not going into details of them because this topic, I hope many things, many terminologies you already know. That what is access type? You know that आपको अपडेशन के लिए सही है या इंसर्शन के लिए सही है. देन एक्सेस टाइम, आपको पता है कि अपडेशन में क्या टाइम लगेगा या इंसर्शन में कैसा टाइम लगेगा. उस पार्टिकुलर एक्सेस टाइम के ऊपर डिपेंड करके हम कौन सा क्या कहाँ यूज करना है, ये हम डिटरमाइन करेंगे. इसी तरह स्पेस ज्यादा लगेगा तो हम कौन सा वाला यूज करेंगे. दिस क्वेश्चन आई एम गोइंग टू आस्क, आई विल गिव यू एज एन असाइनमेंट, डोंट वरी. देन इंडेक्सिंग का जो टाइम था और जो क्या बोलते हैं टाइप था, मैंने अभी बता ही दिया आपको व्हाट इज दैट. देन टू मोर थिंग्स यू हैव टू नो, दैट इज डेंस इंडेक्स एंड वन इज स्पार्स इंडेक्स. नाउ डेंस इंडेक्स क्या है, व्हाट इज डेंस इंडेक्स? डेंस इंडेक्स मींस एन इंडेक्स रिकॉर्ड अपीयर्स फॉर एवरी सर्च की वैल्यू इन द फाइल. मतलब जितने भी फाइल्स में सर्च की होगा सबके लिए एक इंडेक्स रिकॉर्ड होगा. For every search key, there will be an index record. Kindly note it down. Then that will be dense index. But if that index records only is kept only for few records, मतलब सबके लिए हम नहीं determine कर रहे हैं, सबके लिए हम index record नहीं रख रहे हैं, तो वो कहलाएगा आपका क्या, sparse index. An index record that appears only for some values in the file, that is sparse. Okay. Now, second question to you, what is the difference between dense index and sparse index? मैंने अभी कहा आप लोगों को, dense index जहां हम सब सारे index record maintain कर रहे हैं सभी के लिए, मतलब सारे search keys के लिए हम index record maintain कर रहे हैं, but sparse में क्या कर रहे थे, only for few values हम index record maintain कर रहे हैं. तो second question of this lecture is the difference between dense index and sparse index. Is my question clear to you? Now look at this diagram.
Yes, sir.
Okay, look at this diagram quickly. So see, this is the example of dense index because you can see that these are the search keys, and for These are the searches, and for everything, we are keeping this index record. Okay. But if I show you the sparse index, you will see we are keeping the index record only for few. Like this, look at this whole table. But we are keeping only for what? Brighton, Manion, and Redwood only, not for all. So this will be called as what? Sparse index, okay? Got it? One's dense index, for all we are keeping the index record. One sparse index, we are keeping the sparse record only for few. Then multi-level index means what? We are maintaining more than one index record, means outer index. Outer index is pointing to some inner index, and inner index also some blocks are there. And in that blocks only, we are keeping the actual reference where the data is stored. This means to say that we are not keeping the reference in the outer index. मतलब ये बोलना चाह रहा हूँ मैं कि data reference कहाँ मिलेगा वो सारे जितने भी data references हैं वो एक ही table में हम नहीं रख रहे हैं. Outer index में क्या रख रहे हैं हम? Outer index में हम inner index का blocks का information रख रहे हैं और वो inner blocks हैं और वो inner blocks में हम क्या कर रहे हैं? जहाँ actually data होगा, जहाँ actually data references होगा, वो references हम inner block में रख रहे हैं. तो what I mean to say that outer index is pointing to some inner index blocks, like block 0, block 1, and that block is only pointing to that data, where the data is being stored. Is this thing is clear to you?
Yes, sir.
Very good. So similarly, one more thing, if multi-level index is clear, then we have our very popular one that is known as B-tree index. And do mind it that we maximum time use this B-tree index. And main benefit of B-tree index is that it is dynamic. It is fully dynamic. It can grow and shrink as per the requirements. Now, three levels of B-tree nodes. These things you have to note. First, what? Root node, branch node, leaf node. So B-tree mein kya kya levels hai? Root node contains the node pointers to branch node. Okay. Then branch node contains pointers to the leaf or other branch node. And leaf node contains index items and horizontal pointers to other leaf nodes. So iska thoda sa diagram aap draw karne ki koshish karoge. If you go for drawing this diagram, this root node is containing nodes to point, node pointer to some other branch node. Okay, branch node kya hoga? Branch node may point to some other branch node or it may point to some what? Leaf. Okay, ye jaise suppose branch node hai, ye bhi branch node hai, ye bhi branch node hai, aur ye suppose leaf node hai. Leaf node ka kya characteristics hai? What is the characteristics of leaf node? It will have no further growth or it will be not growing further or it will not have any side node. Now, leaf node mein kya hoga? It will contain index item and horizontal pointers to other leaf node. So, ek leaf node, dusra leaf node ko point out kar sakta hai, right? So, that is the B-tree. I'm repeating again. Root node contains the node pointers to the branch node. Branch nodes contain the pointer to either branch, other branch nodes or leaf nodes. And leaf nodes contain the very, very important part. That is the index items or the horizontal pointer to other leaf node. You got it? So today's third question is that you need to tell me what exactly we keep in the leaf node of a B-tree. Got my question? Clear my question?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So as I have shown you just, the structure will be like this. This is the root node. Root node is pointing to branch node. Branch node may point to other branch node or it may point to the leaf nodes. And leaf node may point to other leaf. And this is maximum times we use this B-tree. What is the reason behind that? Because B-tree is dynamic in nature, so it can grow and shrink as part of requirement is concerned. Okay. Now, next thing that in SQL, how you go for creating this index? Very simple command. Create index, index name on table, name, column name. So create index, so hum create table ka index use karte create table, similarly create index. इंडेक्स का कुछ नाम दे दोगे ऑन टेबल, टेबल नेम मतलब सपोज स्टूडेंट, सपोज एम्प्लॉय, देन किस कॉलम के ऊपर आप बना रहे हो वो कॉलम का नाम देना पड़ेगा. ओके, नाउ लास्ट क्वेश्चन टू यू दैट यू ऑब्जर्व दिस टू सिंटैक्सेस एंड यू विल लेट मी नो दैट व्हाट एक्चुअली वी आर ट्राइंग टू डू विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस. एज आई हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड द syntax for creating the index. I'm repeating the syntax again. Create index, index name, मतलब index का नाम दोगे, on table name, किस table के ऊपर, and column name, which table, which column name के ऊपर, मतलब which column के ऊपर आप index create कर रहे हैं. तो ये syntax को देखे, इन दोनों में क्या हो रहा है, ये आप मुझे बताओगे, before 6 p.m. of today, all should answer in that particular video lecture. Okay? My question clear? You have taken the screenshot? Thank you.
Yes, sir.
So that's all for today. I hope this lecture about indexing is very much clear to you. And whatever the topics that I have discussed is very, very important. So do mind it and do revise this lecture if it is needed and come throughout the answers of the questions before the time given to you.